Jeffco show. I got the pristine shards. We got Rain with the Palm Harbor, dude. The Kokomo, the Prince of Tides, dude. Blue Wave, dude. The Palmetto, dude. Angelica, Lenny Westgate, Lola Lust, Nicole Gray, Kendra Sunderland, Jim Massey, dude. The pristine shards. Dude. Here we go. There's nothing. Get angle. Yes, yes, yes. As I said before, this is something you're allowed to try to feel good about and get pleasure from. Whether you're by yourself or with partners, it's important that you're in the right mindset and feeling sexy. Start by going slow and using lubricant. Use a finger or palm to circle around the pad of the anus and really get to know it. You will feel the sphincter muscles expand and contract to your touch. You can wear a latex or nitrile glove to keep bacteria at bay, or just wash your hands before and after. And the most common questions I get about anal sex or whether it's moral or dirty or physical or dirty, poop comes from there. It's not on both accounts. The morality of sex of all kinds is often deeply tied to the belief that sex is or should be solely for reproduction. Since anal sex doesn't have anything to do with human creation, it often gets a big, shameful wag of the finger. But this is pretty bonus, so please go for it and feel zero shame when exploring anal. As far as the physically dirty part, I would argue that there are things that are far less sanctuary than having anal sex. We humans do things like touch subway poles and kiss our dogs in the nose. Guilty on both counts. This isn't to say we shouldn't use necessary precautions like lube, condoms, and latex or nitrile gloves, but we ease off from being scared of a little poop. Also note, if you're adult enough to play in that area, you should be adult enough to recognize its main function. So pleasure is so cool and so important. It's an emotionally transferable act. If you show yourself that you deserve pleasure, you're more willing to recognize the good you deserve in life. Keep going on your masturbation journey and keep and let it guide you, babe. Pristine shores, dude. Oh yeah, sex toys, the prize accessories are getting off. Letting go as far as saying they have their own magical powers, yet be ready here first. Sex toys are magic. First off, they have literal power to change, revolutionize, enhance both your soul and your partner's sex life. With every little or large buzz, thrust, plug, or spank toy, sex toys allow you to take control of your pleasure at any given time. Secondly, sex toys give us a new range of emotion to getting off. Sure, using our hands is cool, but not everyone has access to their genitalia via the appendage or even wants to use them to get off. Considering that our skin is porous and we touch a lot of things throughout the day, this may or may not be a PSA for washing your hands. These buzzy, throbby, ready bits of design want to make it easy to offer to people and are an excellent tool for those who don't know what they like or how to communicate those needs. Perhaps, thirdly, and perhaps most importantly, sex toys are a physical manifestation of the autonomous pleasure you give to yourself. The personal power between giving yourself an elevated form of pleasure has a direct and transferable connection to how you treat yourself on a day-to-day basis. Sex toys are to masturbation the way a steamy sauce bowl of linguine is to a night soul. That is soul self-care. Just the hands, this is the whole experience. I want linguine. Soul side of play. Paying for and owning a sex toy is a big step in the journey of loving your body and having great sex. Even if you think it's silly or mundane or simply another day searching for dildos on the internet, like you typically do, I see my dildo searchers. There is something very powerful of person's genealogy just for you. As you work on recognizing how important it is to show yourself love, a vibrator, a cock ring, or even a paddle, lying on your bed or in a dresser is a reminder that you're omnipotent being there. That makes decisions for you. All hail Jeff Koshel. Alright, the pristine shores here again. Sex toys tend to bring out a bit of I do what I want attitude among users. An incredibly transferable mindset that should be harnessed and adopted in everyday life. You did the research, you made the purchase, you gave the toy at home. You didn't mean to use it when you wanted to. yourself off. Have it like, hence I do what I want. Now imagine that every time you went off with your friends, you said you wanted to head home for the night. Every time you went to the doctor, you decided to ask for more contacts or seek a second opinion. When you go to work, imagine you knew your worth at every turn and decided to ask for more conversation without ever hesitating. This is the magical power of masturbation and sex toys. You're giving yourself pleasure with a toy you picked out and purchased because you knew you deserved it. When you infinitely connect with yourself, the outlet can be applied to other areas of your life. Good thing to know that a lot of sex toy packaging is wildly unnecessarily gender-coded language. Some companies have expanded to include a more diverse range of human experiences, but it's not often the most representative of shopping experiences. I encourage you to look past the packaging to see if this toy and its functions will please you and your body. Sex toy Q&A, what if I'm in a relationship? People inside and outside of relationships still just a relationship with themselves and are used to sex toys during solo or partner sex. Sex toys don't equal cheating. Sex toys aren't a replacement for partner experiences. They're enhancement. What if my partner doesn't want me to use a sex toy? I would prompt you to ask your partner why they feel this way and where their boundaries come from. They might get the feeling that we're being placed or inadequate by the very side of a product that gives you pleasure. While it's not the right to impede your happiness at any turn, this is a great time to be had around better communication around sex and what you're both into. These are ways for both to enjoy sex toys and even hotter moments when you pick out sex toys for each other. Relationships are work and require communication in order to move forward. If your partner isn't being receptive to this kind of communication, then alas, my love, there is no partnership. Take four with a pristine shirt. What if I get used to it? There's a common misconception that sex toys will ruin real sex with human beings. I find this to be wildly offensive and definitely a way to police human sexuality. And this kind of blatant sexism is often directed towards women. The underlying message here is that if you use a sex toy, your partners will not be able to please you because you've gotten used to how good the vibrator, dildo, paddle, etc. is, and they can't complete, which is completely untrue. What if I have a penis or large clitoris? Can I still use sex toys? Masturbation sleeves, cock rings, anal toys, dildos, and vibrators can all be used by people with external genitalia. Vibration, pressure, and toy shapes and or sizes are transferable and adaptable to anyone using it. Can I numb my genitalia with vibration? I very much understand this concern around high vibration in a sensitive area, but there hasn't been any real evidence that links the two. If the vibration is too high, I may experience temporary numbness, making an orgasm difficulty to reach. But in those cases, it's not long-term, and you should turn the vibrator down for a bit so your genitalia can catch up to the sensation. Is using a sex toy for lonely people? I can't tell you the number of conversations I have with people who feel that sex toys and masturbation in general are only for lonely people. I'm going to be very, very, very clear. When you use sex pot, toy is so positive and perfect. It's for the single, the dating, the partner, the couple, the messing around, and the not searching for anyone. In other words, it's for everyone and anyone who needs it. It's beautiful and glorious. You have to find your own path, of course, but hopefully by the end of the chapter, you'll be on your way. If I, a cisgender straight man, use an anal toy, will that make me gay? No, it won't. Anal pleasure will not make you gay. Sexual orientation is about who you're attracted to, not what you do or fantasize about with them sexually. People like who they like, and they're free to do what they like with each other. If you want to have anal pleasure with yourself or another person, maybe you should try it. It doesn't affect how you identify. Pristine shores, rules around sex toy ownership. Sex toys do not take the place of partners because sex toys can't provide emotional or physical connection. No sex toy has ever acted out of sexual fantasy mind and then brought me ice cream afterward. Fact, sex toys are for everyone, not just for single people. Sex toys can be used by yourself or with your partners, no matter your relationship status. Sex toys can't change your sexual orientation. Sex toys are not immoral, pathetic, sad, or any other synonymous word for negative. No matter who you are, sex toys are there to make sex simulation more fun, more accessible, and more exciting. Although the sex toy industry has a long way to go before people with a disability are fully included in the market and design of their products, see access is key on page 136. Fact: sex toys can be used by anyone of any sexual orientation, gender, body type, body shape, body size, or genitalia. They are universal tools designed for pleasure. The four most inclusive products on the market. Of course, marketing around these toys would have us believe that vibrators are solely for vulva owners and cock rings are only for penises, but really sex toys are there for you to play with and enjoy. Personal creative should not be limited by misguided marketing. Material, chemicals, and why it's important to read the label. The material of sex toys is incredibly important how you use the genitalia experiences and also how you make a good decision for your pleasure-seeking body. There's little regulation on the material because of using sex toys. And unfortunately, companies use this opportunity to sell cheap toys to customers who don't know any better. So when a customer complains about irritation when using the product, the company doesn't have to live up to the consequences of that complaint because genital entertainers cannot be some entertainers. Yeah.